缅甸局势持续发酵，联合国安理会周二在英国的倡议下进行紧急闭门会议，但并没有立即采取行动。美国国务院已经正式认定缅甸军方夺取政权为政变。美国智库威尔逊中心亚洲项目的分析人士卢卡斯·麦耶斯认为，国际社会对缅甸军方施加的压力将主要来自美国及盟友。
So I think generally the main pressure that we will see against the coup leaders will come from the United States and its allies, potentially the European Union as well, although we will see. I think in general, the United States will reimpose sanctions and enhance its diplomatic pressure against the Myanmar government. But at this time, there's not a lot that could be done through the United Nations due to China's presence and its veto on the Security Council.And I also anticipate that China will step in to defend Myanmar as it has some key interests in the country that it does not want to see harmed by any changing government.
麦耶斯对缅甸军方执政的前景感到悲观。他认为，虽然缅甸全国民主联盟存在问题，也有很大的改进空间，但缅甸民主进程过去十年仍然取得了一定的进展。目前的军事政变使民主进程遭遇重大挫折。
According to my analysis, the military seems unlikely to restart the democratization process in Myanmar, however troubled it was in the last 10 years, at least there was some progress. Now, I see this as a serious setback for the hopes in Myanmar that they could embark on democratization. In general, the leadership of the coup, Senior General Min Aung Hlaing,take a dim view of the NLD and have for some time. So I see this as significant that they've decided to launch a coup. Clearly, they've decided that standing by while the democratization process unfolds is no longer in their interest as the military.